As mentioned, Indonesia, who have blown us away in this tournament. They really have, the leading goal scorers. Nine players then changed by Indra Shafri. And the only two that remain are Komang in defence and a little bit further forwards, Witan Sulaiman. Witan scoring three goals in the last edition of this competition, has started every single game so far for Indonesia. That's why everybody else has been relegated to the bench. It's a strong squad. We saw that against the Cambodian side. He has tweaked and tinkered, and it isn't his very first official starting lineup that they started with the Philippines. Players have forced their way into the starting lineup going in to this semi-final. Has been cool, has been calm, been collected as well on the sidelines, and that is why he is in charge of that Indonesian side. As for Philippe Trussier, he turns around, he makes six changes. Kouamri remain in goal. There's one change in the back three. Luang Doikong comes back in. Duc Phu comes back in, as does Tuan Tai, to give them that width in wide areas. Van Kang is out, Xuan Tien is out, so Vo Min Truong comes in, as does Tai Son, who has been fantastic throughout this tournament. But all talk and all eyes will be on number nine, Nguyen Van Tung. He replaces Van Truong, but Van Tung is their main go-to guy when they go forwards, being a joint top scorer of the competition with four goals. We're in for a belter. So it's the winners of Group A, Indonesia, taking on the runners-up of Group B, Vietnam. It's Vietnam in the white strip that get us underway. To say the pitch is looking absolutely magnificent. All those changes made by Trussier, because it was only 48 hours ago that Vietnam did play against Thailand. Indonesia had an extra day's rest, but a lot of the players were rested for that last game. Being strong in the challenge and the tackle, Mazahan, who plays over in Japan, of course. So Pratama Ahan coming all the way across, he'll be the one that will launch this one in. It's a really big throw and a free header. What a finish from the man that started every game for Indonesia, Komang Teguh. He came and arrived late on and buried that header into the corner. What a throw that is. Look at the trajectory, it's so flat, but he just strolled in there unmarked, Komang, and made absolutely no mistake. Dream start for Indonesia. It's his first goal of the tournament, Komang. But what a vitally important goal that could be. When Van Tong can drop in between the lines and cause all sorts of problems. Example here, Min Truong pulls it back. Van Tong with a half chance. Great run from out to in. Marcus Kaffer just got caught ball watching, and it allowed Vo Min Truong to try and pull it back. How about that on the turn from the big man? Not a million miles away. Vietnam getting closer. Ball flicked back in and it's glanced up and over. And who else but the big man himself, Nguyen Van Tung. He scored the opening goal of their campaign. And it was a header. And that was against Lao. He scored with another header here. What a ball whipped in. He gets in front of Rizky Dido and just gets a faint glance on it. It goes up and over. Hamano Ali in goal, giving him absolutely no chance. Game back on, 100%. Straight swaps all round though. No doubt about that as we get going for the second half, and it is the red team of Indonesia kicking from right to left. So launched right in there, the keeper's had a little bit of a flap, and now the volley back in. Marcelino! Was it the last touch come off the defender, Ferrari? Well, we'll have to see the replay. Marcelino just drilled it in. They've had two long throws in the game and they have scored two goals, and it is Ferrari that has scored this. There's that throw again. Poor goalkeeping to push it back into play. Marcelino drills it goalbound, and the centre-back who's come on at half-time to replace the other centre-back has scored with his calf, just a faint little flick. Perfect start to the second 45 minutes then for Indonesia. Vietnam will throw absolutely everything forward, including the centre-backs. Nguyen Quoc Dang, he carries his run on forwards. Lee Van Do has space in behind. Van Trong checks back. Quoc Dang delivers decent ball as well. Packed into his own net though. And it's the skipper who's put it past his own keeper, Rizky Rido. Trussier took the gamble, bought on Van Kang and bought on Van Truong, because he knew against 10 men they can sacrifice another body to push forwards, and it's paid dividends. But Tang is the man that's whacked it in and just delivered it. And actually it's not Rizky Rido, it's Bagas Kafa that puts the ball past his own keeper. Heartbreak for him. Put your left foot through the ball, son. He's tried to hack at it with his right, and because of that and the spin on the ball, it's come off his shin and into the back of the net. Vietnam all square. Oh, and there's the glancing header. What a save. Van Tong thought that was in. He's got in front of his man and glanced it into that far post area. Pushed away to safety. Fernando Ari, what a save that was. Fingertips. Difficult to see if it was creeping in or not. You'll see from this sort of angle though. Oh, it is, it's creeping in. And now a friend just caught out of position. Five white shirts forwards. Kong Den trying to play it on, but just got dispossessed. And that's a brilliant touch. And that's very, very well played from Telfony. And now Fajar at the other end. Fajar checks back inside, waits for support. Fajar goes himself. Brilliant block. Telfony picks up the loose ball. Telfony! Can you believe it? Can you believe it? The 10 men have stung Vietnam. Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. Three minutes left on the clock, and Vietnam have conceded against the 10 men of Indonesia. It looked like nothing was going on. They blocked the shot. Tolfani had all the space closed down and somehow chops it back through the legs of the defender and across Quan Van Thuan in goal to score. And almost with the last kick of the game, Indonesia take the lead. Everyone will just be pushed forwards now. It was 5 minutes 50 seconds, 6 minutes into stoppage time. The question is now, are we going to have an equaliser? Amandoari down to his left. Thuan Thien trying to find that bottom corner. Well, we said there'd be more drama left in this one, and there certainly has been. Irfan, they've won the corner. Bagas looked to fire it across goal rather than keep it in the corner. And you can see Indra Shafi calming everyone down, but he doesn't need to. The whistle goes. Vietnam are finally beaten in the SEA Games. It's taken a monumental effort from Indonesia. Unbelievable scenes at the Olympic Stadium. Down to 10 men for over half an hour of that match at the end. But Tolfani, 6 minutes into stoppage time, breaks the hearts of the Vietnamese. But what a performance from Indonesia.